Yo, what's good? I'm doing an Amazon gift card giveaway 3 times in this video. So make sure you watch until the end, all right? So you can cop you one. Yeah.
Yo, what's good, everybody? It's your boy, Trey, back with another video. And this is another vlog.
Another one.
So yeah, I'm trying to really get into this blogging thing more and more. So if y'all like my vlogs, make sure that y'all, you know, like down below, comment y'all favorite part of the vlog and all that good stuff. Look, I got some stuff going on at my house right now. I just literally went outside a few days ago and my front yard was full of water. Not full of water like it done flooded or something. It ain't no New Orleans stuff going on. That ain't what I'm saying. But a matter of fact, let me show y'all because it's still happening right now. I saw water and I didn't know where it was coming from. And I'm thinking maybe it's the rain, right? But it wasn't the rain. Ain't no rainwater just gonna sit for like, you know, a good 4 or 5 days. It's gonna soak into the ground or it's gonna evaporate up into the sky or something like that. This is what I saw first. I saw setting water right here, and then I noticed before these tracks that y'all see, before that even got into the picture, back up, what I noticed was water sitting around the tree right there. So evidently it had to have been running from somewhere up here and going down there. So they came out, they cut the grass. They use this big old like tractor looking thing, and as you can see, they left all these marks and tire tracks and stuff into the ground because it's so saturated with water. You can see the water sitting inside of, like, y'all see that? Look, the water's just sitting inside of these little crevices where they done jacked up the yard basically down. Even all the way down there, it's all jacked up and all that stuff. But what I did was, I got this bush right here, and I don't know what's going on with this bush. It ain't fall yet. It's like it's brown and green. It's doing some weird stuff. Some of it's dead. I don't know if it's some stuff going on up under the ground, which I think it is. But what I feel like happened is some roots from this bush have gone down into the ground and kind of struck a pole or something. Because I moved the straw back from around here and I noticed this little spot of water. And if you look closely, let me zoom in, you can see it's moving the sediment in the dirt. Y'all see that? Y'all see that? It's just coming up out the ground. And I'm thankful, look at that. But I'm thankful that it's not sewage water, because that wouldn't be good, because I don't want to be smelling no sewage water. But it's fresh water, but it's just coming up through the ground. So I got somebody just coming out, actually, in a few minutes. They should be here by now, but they on the way. They're probably going to have to dig up all of this. This whole bush is going to have to be dug up. And they're going to have to really see what's going on. So I don't know if I'm going to end up not having a bush no more, even though I don't even know if this bush any good. I might need to, you know, get a new kind of bush put out here. Something like that over there instead of this bush. It's weird. I came outside one day and it was 3 berries, 2 blackberries and a red berry. They just popped up on the bush nowhere. And then the bugs came and ate them, or the birds came and ate them. Somebody came and ate them, but yeah, anyway, so. I really need to wash my car. I really need to go get it washed. But it's been raining so much, like every other day it's raining. And I like the fact that it still looks clean. I like the fact that it still kind of looks clean.
You can see, like, all this dirt. It bothers me. But if you're far back, you can't really even tell that it's really dirty. But, yeah, hopefully I get to go to the car wash tomorrow, probably.
Later. All
right, so I'm at the grocery store, y'all. My mind was telling me no.
My mind's telling me no.
But my body said that I could do it today, so. About to, do I want to hit this up? Or do I want to hit something up down here?
All right, so it's crazy. I'm allergic to dairy. I'm really allergic to dairy. But there comes a point every now and then that I feel like I can eat it. Sometimes it makes me sick and I throw up, but sometimes I be all right. So let me decide what I want to get.
I did do this for a little. I can eat that. Some ice creams I can eat, some of them I can't. I do like the salted caramel core, but I really would want some cookie dough, and I don't see no cookie dough. I don't see that. So, you know what? My body just said, don't worry about it.
Crazy. Like, on my way up here, I was seriously feeling like I could eat ice cream, but as soon as I got to looking at it, it was like, no, my body said, no, it's gonna make you sick, so I had to put it back. Actually, I needed to pick it up, but yeah. So I'm finna, you know, see what else is up here.
Should I get some cake today? I feel like I need some sugar. I don't know what to do. What is this? This is just chocolate. It looks like a light, creamy chocolate too. This one has disappointed me in the past. I've liked it and then it's disappointed me at the same time. I think I'll just get this. Cool, I'll just get this small piece of cake.
All right, so I do want to get some juice. I have a lot of juice at home because I drink a lot of juice, but I feel like I need some more juice. And I'm trying to see if they got my favorite. And they do. I love Simply Orange with pineapple. So,
comment down below if y'all like this, if y'all ever tried it. That one got the tab sticking up, so I'm not gonna get that one. I'll get this one.
How am I look today?
Hi, how are you?
I'm pretty good. How are you?
I'm fine. You ordered me already.
All right, I want to get a large pineapple freeze.
Mm-hmm.
That'll be all.
Alrighty. $2.99.
Thank you.
Wow, I am shocked as hell. They normally say, "Oh, it's down. It's down. Our freeze machine is down, it's down, it's down. The freeze machine is down." But it's working today. Hell's about to freeze over. Let me get my goddamn pineapple freeze before it freeze over though.
Sorry, it's DJ.
All right, so that's just where I wanted to get my drink from. Comment down below if any of y'all out there be doing the same thing. You gotta get one meal from five different places, because I'm in another place now.
A little longer than a few minutes later.
Man,
are they open?
They motherfucking burned down. I don't know. It don't look right. I saw they had like some, like, you know, like the stuff to be up in the ceiling, the installation and stuff, was pulled out and thrown on the ground, and it had burn marks on it. And then when I looked through the window at the drive-thru, it looked like part of the ceiling was falling in. So, no fish for me today. Back at Taco Bell now, because that looks like what I'm gonna have to eat today. All right, so y'all, I'm going to another spot, which is actually a better spot and a spot that I really like to go to.
Two squid. Yes. I want those fried too. Everything's fried. One tilapia.
All
An order of hush puppies. Yes.
So now I'm outside waiting on my food. They got it like set up to where once you place your order, they text your phone, tell you to come back in and get it, because it's kind of a lot here that are actually waiting all on their food. And yeah, so I'm debating, should I just stand right here on the curb or should I just go wait in my car? It's hot, but it's not really all that hot right now. But look at this, man. I'm trying to remember what this used to be across the street. I think it was like, it's crazy. I'm on Covington Highway right now in Decatur. Decatur, if y'all were wondering. So y'all see the sign says New Orleans Seafood, but this is definitely Decatur, Georgia. I'm about to go set up my car today. Text my phone.
15 minutes later.
All right, so y'all, I'm gonna show y'all what I actually got. But before I actually touch this food, give me some sanitizer right quick. Gotta get that. And I got, look at that. I got some hush puppies, y'all see that. I got some fried squid. That's what these little pieces are right here. This little curly looking stuff, that's fried squid. Yummy, 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 I like it. Then the squid body, which is the calamari. Pretty sure y'all should know that. And then I got some, this is a fried lobster tail. Look at that. That's gonna be good. Then I got some, you can see it up under here, some scallops, some fried scallops. That's what that is back up in there. But yeah, y'all see that. All right, so y'all, this has officially become a vlog, outing, and mukbang all in one. I'm at the house. Y'all already seen the food. I mean, I highly recommend, if you are in the Atlanta, Metro Atlanta area, and you are looking for some good seafood, like, I'm from Louisiana, so of course, I know good seafood. Of course, I would have got crab legs, but I didn't feel like no crab legs and nothing like that today. So, y'all saw what I got. I got the lobster tail right here. I'm going to eat that. And then scallops, the squid. Some people be scared of squid. Talking about it look like, you know, it don't look right, but I like squid. Y'all see, it look like little octopus body. That's what it looked like. But yeah, and then I got some tilapia. I did get everything fried. It is what it is. But eat these scallops, fried scallops. I'm not gonna dip it in nothing right now, but I did get some cocktail sauce and some tartar sauce. Just as I figured, my drink was gonna be gone by the time I actually got home, back to the house to eat my food. My drink was gonna be gone. So, I'm gonna show y'all, I'm not a drinker, but I like to mix drinks. Let me show y'all what I do. All right, so look, I got the OJ, pineapple OJ that I just got from the grocery store. Raz Cranberry LaCroix, this is a sparkling water. Topo Chico. Now, if y'all don't know what Topo Chico is, if y'all have ever been trying to like break the habit of drinking soda, but you still want something that got that bite, this right here got that bite. And it tastes pretty good. It really tastes good, because some sparkling waters, they don't be good. But this right here, certified Topo Chico. Y'all see that? It's A1. All right, so this is what we're gonna do. No ice, because ice is take up room for your drink. This gotta be open with one of these bottle openers. Oops. Y'all ain't see that. So right about there, because that's all we need, because that is strong. This stuff right here is strong. Shake it by simply, because we gotta get that pulp circulating in there. almost all the way to the top, almost, but not completely. Finish it off with a little bit of LaCroix. Yep, and that's it. That's so good, so good. Let's see what this lobster talking about. They did cut it down the middle so it can get fried inside. Real good. Y'all see that? Yes, y'all see that? Fried lobster meat. I love seafood. I just can't eat it the way I used to. So good. This is cooked just right. Let's talk about, I guess, I'm gonna give y'all some of my opinions on some things that have been going on. And if y'all agree, disagree, or have something, you know, different to say, comment down below. First off, Brandy. Brandy just released the album. Her first album in 8 years. Now, I like Brandy. I like Brandy a lot. But this album that she just released, notice I said, but it ain't it. And I'm gonna tell you why. I feel like this is the first album that she has done as, I guess, pretty much an independent artist on her own label. So she didn't have big brand, you know, big record deal backing from Atlantic and all of that stuff. She did this on her own label, and you can tell, you can always tell when an artist does that pretty much almost all the time, because it's just like the quality of the records is not the same, the quality of the recording is not the same. Not saying that she's vocally not there, but I'm saying I feel like almost every song on the album sounds like a background album, like it's all background, like her voice is so embedded and deep inside of the actual tracks and the rhythm and the beat that you can't, it's like you can't differentiate, that is a word, differentiate, I might have said it wrong, but differentiate her voice, her vocal, her lead vocal from background vocal. Everything's just muddy and mashed together, and I thought the mixing and the engineering of the track, I feel like the songs are good, but if she really wants this to really work, she needs to pull the album, re-release it after it's been like remixed, remastered, like one of those moves, and then it'll probably be, you know, it'll be a really, really good solid album. But I can't understand, if I can't understand what you're saying, it reminds me of that time period, like when Janet Jackson did the Demeter Joe album, and you couldn't understand a word she was saying for most of those songs. That's what it reminds me of. That's just my opinion on that. Talk about some YouTubers that I like to watch that I feel y'all should watch. I like Dre and Ken Empire. Their videos are pretty funny, so check them out. I'm going to leave their link down in the description, which I never really do that, but I'll do it. But yeah, check out Dre and Ken Empire. Also, somebody else that I really like that I've been watching for years, Ashley Miller. Now, if you like to watch like stuff that come on TV right now, she does a lot of reviews about stuff.
And she's funny. She's really funny. She makes the episodes that she reviews more entertaining than the episodes themselves. Like, for real. Like, a lot of the stuff that she reviews, I don't watch. But I watch her review because it's funny. I'm chewing this lobster. If you're on YouTube, and you're watching YouTube, there's no way that you cannot know who the Ace family is. I watch the Ace family. I do. I also watch... Well, okay. I just recently started watching the Prince family. And let me tell you this. Now, I've seen a few videos here and there, like, a while back. I never subscribed. No matter of fact, I'm going to be honest, I'm still not subscribed. But I do watch their videos because they recently just did this whole thing about Damien and his 12-year-old brother liking his wife and a whole lot of old stuff. And it really kind of, I knew that it was fake entertainment, but at least it was entertainment. Like, some good acting. For real, good acting. Like, I wasn't fooled, but good acting. I was entertained. I might subscribe. I might. What the hell is this? Something was in the lobster that I don't recognize, and it don't look like it's supposed to be there, so I'm going to check that part out. Mm-mm. I don't know about that one. See that good old sauce on there? You want some? I like to watch Phase Rug. I want to be the black Phase Rug. He has a lot of subscribers. His videos are always full of positivity. Positivity. That's why I like him. I mean, he's always doing good stuff for people. And, like, when I say, if I really want to say that I'm looking at him on his videos for one reason, it would be because he's so inspiring and motivating. Like, if I could actually, I aspire to be the type of YouTuber that he is because he uploads every day or every other day. I swear, I wish that I could be like him, for real. I used to watch Pretty Boy Fredo, especially when he did a lot of videos with Jasmine, but I slacked off a little bit. Funny Mike, I watched Funny Mike. I watched, What is the name? I watch a lot of, like, here and there stuff with movies and stuff. So it's not actually, like, people, but it's movies on YouTube. Definitely watch them. Because I don't like cable. I like the ability to be able to watch what I want when I want. Uninterrupted, you know. Which is why streaming is a big thing now. I feel like it's only a couple of years before YouTube and streaming completely replaces cable television. It's only a matter of time. But they know it. That's why a lot of the networks have gone to streaming. They're on streaming sites. This calamari is kind of tough. Let me try the fish. See if it's cooked good. Oh no! It was at the bottom, so it got grease on it. I'm gonna go to the side that don't have a lot of grease on it and let the greasy side sit on a piece of napkin to let the grease kind of get out of there. But let's see. Smells decent. Okay. Pretty good. All right. So this video has been kind of long. But thank y'all for watching my video. And if you are not subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Plus, if you like this video, like it down below, share it, hit me up on Instagram. Send me some DMs of videos y'all want to see me do. I got some stuff in mind that I got that's about to come up, so make sure y'all subscribe for that. And I hope y'all decided to watch this video to the end. For those of y'all that have watched my video to the end, I'll drop these Amazon codes. So, congratulations. So, whoever gets the Amazon code, and uses it on Amazon. This is my giveaway for y'all for watching my videos. I appreciate the support. And until next time, it's your boy Trey. And I'm out. Peace. My swag, soft, my swag, ooh, my swag, not my swag, you, my swag, he, my swag, huh, my swag, you, my swag, stuff, my swag, fly, my swag, tight, your swag, wrong, my swag, not my swag, gone, your swag, off, it just flat line, so good, nah, I swag a lot, cause my swag a mean, my swag shoes, and my swag a jeans, my swag a train, and my swag a hat, my swag the on point everywhere, watch me spray, home, my swag alone, cause my swag is Gucci, my swag and I don't now take a pick, but I strike the pose, and my swag a shake, for my swag a phone.